The permits granted by ERA mean that the invaders and companies are licensed to conduct an installation business countrywide. ERA Chief Executive Officer says the authority certified 2,870 persons specifically under classes C and D, while 1,000 in the other classes, including companies.
There are various interventions, including this very one today, to ensure that we engage the wire persons that we authorize through certification to be able to do proper electrical installation of premises. Because some of the losses happen because of bad wiremanship.
Permit holders are authorized to carry out electric installation works in authorized places, including residences. Dr. Sarah Wasagali, the ERA chairperson, says the authority loses a significant amount of revenue.
Now, I don't have the figure offhand, but it varies from one period to another. Because this is basically supposed to be handled by the distribution companies like Umeme. They have to move out in the field to check on those who are stealing power. And even the new law that was amended in 2022 is very, very tough on people who steal power. But the figures vary from one period to another. But we've brought it down and we no longer allow that in the tariff. So the licensees have to ensure that they fight those who are stealing power. It eats into their profits.
We are creating our own team. It will be very difficult for a person who has been trained by the Electricity Regulatory Authority to again turn around and do illegal connection. How? They are certified. These are certified. They will come to you. The certificate means that this person is trusted and is going to do the good work. But they are operating in a community, in a society, which has, funny, wiser people.
Through power theft and illegal connections, the country currently generates enough electricity to meet its demand, with the installed generation capacity standing at over 1,378 megawatts. Story by Lucius Kasoma for the news.